pleasure.
Thank you, and thanks for joining this one-to-one session. Thank you.
I can also record, can I?
Yes, I'll just share this with you. Don't worry.
Okay.
And a warm welcome to our one-to-one session, Ritu. Happy to have you for this one-to-one session.
Yeah, I'm so happy. Yeah.
No, I really want to congratulate you for that awesome winning of the challenge with 4,000 plus comments in a 10 Facebook Live. Amazing. Fantastic, Ritu.
Yeah, thank you so much. It was all encouragement by you because I never thought to go live in that way. Yeah.
Okay, now this is how we will do this one-to-one session. So we will, anyhow, I'm also going to share this with everyone. So let everyone get benefited from your life experience also. Okay, so that they can learn from you. At the same time, whatever doubts, questions you have where I can help you also, you can structure it. Okay, so it's more like I'm going to interview you and you can answer whatever you want. So just imagine you are on a big show and I'm interviewing you.
Okay, fine. Great. Yeah, great. Yeah.
So that's how we will run this whole program. Thank you very much, first of all, for accepting and coming over here. Thank you, Ritu.
Thank you.
So let's because I know you are a superwoman. I know that you do multiple things, but probably many people are going to watch this session may not know. So can you have a quick background about you, Ritu, so that I will also know a little bit more about you and everyone can know more about
I had a very, very humble background. I was born in a family, you know, who had huge losses. My father had huge losses, very, very sharif person. My mother had great depression. So I started teaching tuition when I was in class sixth. So with those tuition, you know, money, I would take my books, but, you know, study. So I did Master of Law. I'm gold medalist.
Wow.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Thank you. So when I was preparing for IAS, I met my husband, future husband. So he insisted me not to continue. So then I got married. Then okay. For 16 years, I was housewife because he didn't want me to work. I worked for some time as a lecturer in law faculty, as a law faculty, but not really.
Okay.
I got married, he was doing some job, but slowly, steadily, we grew, you know, as first generation as a businessman. And slowly things went in such a way that he became over ambitious and he expanded so badly, took huge loans to the tune of 40 crores.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and he got into a lot of bad things also, you know, other things. So that time things went so bad. We had so many, more than 100 court cases. So, so everything got so messed up that he got really hopeless. He thought he has lost everything. So because of that, he committed suicide. He shot himself.
Oh my God, I'm sorry to hear that. Okay.
So from there, my journey as entrepreneur started because I told you that I had a choice either to give out or fight back. So I had to,
that was a nice quote from you. Huh? You have only two choices in life: either you give up or fight back. Giving up is not an option. Beautiful
not an
quote.
Option. Yeah. So I had two daughters that time; they were 8 and 13 years old. So I had no support system as such. So, but I really, really fought, really learned a lot, you know, whatever is, but because I had no clue about anything, about business, because I had no background of business. My father was not in business. My husband was also first generation.
Okay.
So I had no clue about what it is. You know, for me, commercial thing was always, you know, I couldn't ask anything from anybody. So it was like that. So now I was in such a mess. But I really, really just made it a point that I will learn. And ultimately, in 4 years' time, loans turned from 40 crore to 60 crore because there was penal interest, all that stuff. So in 2011, I got this Women Entrepreneur of the Year award by Economic Activity Now.
Okay.
Yeah. So I overcame all kind of problems. I've really won a lot of court cases. And my daughters grew very, very well. Now, elder one is in US. She's she finished her master's, now working there, very well settled, doing good. Not married, but otherwise in work. And younger one is doing MBBS.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah. So both are doing extremely well. They are happy.
Okay. So what kind of business are you right now doing, Ritu? I know that you are a life coach. Okay. I'm going to talk about that a little later. I will ask you in depth about how did you go there. But what are the other business you are right now doing?
I have industry. I manufacture synthetic leather, PU and PVC leather. Okay. Yeah, okay. I supply to good OEMs in India, like Tata, yeah, Paragon, BKC, you know, Relaxo, all these kind of people, Titan, and I supply to medical industry also. So I have real estate business, but slowly and steadily I have, coming out of it, real estate business. Somewhere after my daughters, you know, they took their own kind of journey, whatever they wanted to. So after that, I started losing interest in business because
I think that the motivation to win, you got that win probably that got slowly dissolving. Okay.
Yeah, because that was not my first nature. My first nature, you know, if we see Ikigai, you know, that was not my first love to earn money to really. So,
but you're forced into the business world because of situations.
By default I came. So I thought whatever comes, so I just deal with it. That is my nature. So this is how I, now after that, I thought now it's time to give back to society. So I started really devoting a lot of time, though I'm doing business also very religiously. It's not whatever I do nicely with a lot of commitment and planning. But my heart is not there, you know. So now I want to do more what my heart says. I believe that is my time, you know.
Okay.
My heart is to reach out to maximum lives. How I came into life coaching is that... I was always like, as I mentioned last time in Spotlight, that I am practicing some philosophy. And in that philosophy, we have about 1 lakh members in India. And I'm a North India leader, in North India, I'm a senior leader. So a lot of people come to me for last 20, 25 years. And because of my stories and my life. So they get a lot of encouragement and they really look forward to that. So that was my part, you know, it became natural part to me. Okay. So then I thought, why not to take it as a profession only? Because I'm already doing. No, because I was going to various institutions, various universities, schools, colleges to share my stories, empower people, motivate them, and they would really get motivated, you know.
Wow.
So, So, because in the journey, you know, even in work, I had such a fantastic experience. How did I learn? How did I make teams? And how I dealt with corruption or legal matters or, you know, all kinds of things.
That's a huge experience you got in your... How many people are working in your organization, Ritu?
Sorry, how many? 150 in my industry, they're working. Mm-hmm. Rest in real estate, we have contractor, labor, whatever, you know, depends on work.
So you're managing a huge team, you're managing, you know, every aspect of a business also, and now your love has gone into helping more people, and that's the reason you moved into a full-time professional coaching also right now.
Yes.
That's nice, very good. So what kind of coaching you give, Ritu, and to whom?
Actually, I took even John Maxwell training from US, and then I did Arfin Khan's certified life coaching course.
Okay.
So I do basically all kind of coaching, you know, anybody and everybody is my client.
Okay.
But I am doing out of, you know, that relationship and that trust people have in me. They really look forward. You won't believe even today I'm doing these days, I'm doing live. I'm continuing with this live calls. So 4 o'clock sharp, they are on call. I might get late by 1 minute or 2 minutes. They are waiting eagerly, you know, like that. So
excellent. Very good. That consistency is the key to success. And good that you're doing that Facebook Live sharp every day at the same time. Good.
Yeah. So this is my life story. Now I want to take it really forward. You know, I really want to maybe even with passage of time, I want to come out of my business because that's not my heart. I believe what for I'm doing, you know, I've lost sense of purpose, you know, the children, they don't need it. And why do, you know, because you know how the industries work, how, you know, it's not that great. And now after Corona, people will have payment issues. And in any case, in India, that's always an issue. you know. So they bought all materials. You can sell material worth 1,10,000 crores in a day, but you don't ask for money. So that is the kind of scenario.
Very true. Very true. So what made you, because you studied various coaching certifications, but what made you to join Teachers or Leaders Community?
I'm a learner. I love to learn and I believe everything. And but when I attended your webinar, I somehow saw that sincerity and the value in the course. And I also, you know, because I've done few, so I could perceive that how it's going to be and it's really going to benefit. I must say your rates are also very genuine, you know, so you're not asking for too much and you're giving too much good value in that. So that's how I thought I will definitely learn something, and I'm actually learning a lot. Yeah.
What are the things that you've learned so far in our TLC community then?
One is be very original, whatever, you know, you are. You don't need to be something else, someone else, but you're not. And be very spontaneous. You don't need to, you know, that's what I learned. And take action. You don't need to keep planning and reach to perfection before starting taking action. And then ultimately you will reach the goal. So a lot of things I'm learning, I think.
Step by step. What are the courses you've completed in the TLC University? Which are the courses you've already done so far?
I did TIB and then I am working on mastery course as well as TMC. And this one niche I did yesterday in a lot of hurry because I was before I could meet you. I thought let me at least go through what it is. So though I will like to do it properly again, but I have quite an idea about it because I try to rush it through. Yeah, and TBI also I have started.
TBI, that's true. So what are the challenges you're facing? How can I help you?
One is niche. Niche is such a thing because, you know, I don't think so that I am a very, I can give direct value in terms of how they can generate money. Okay. You know, I work more with the minds of people. And they have fantastic results later on. But generally in society, people don't understand. They believe that bas kuch kare and they should get money out of it. You know,
they want that shortcut, gratification they want. No?
Pills they want. So I believe I work at the root level. I don't work, you'll get this fruit. And once roots are strong, then you will get fruits as
Absolutely.
Well.
Absolutely true.
So that is my very, very strong, niche that I have. But how to put it across so that people really understand. Those who know me, I don't ask for money. Those who don't know me, what to offer.
So, Ritu, to whom would you like to really serve? Okay. There are different varieties of audience. Your life story, for example, from a very, very difficult background, and you've seen all the ups and downs in your life, including the death of your husband and the loans, and you got out of it, and you're now running a successful industry. So are you someone who is interested to share that life story and that compassion and that passion and desire to women entrepreneurs? Is that what is your calling is? Or in general, to any woman who really wants to live a life of their own, whom do you think you really can strike chord with? Okay, is there anyone whom you, because in the last 25 years, you have met a lot of people, as you mentioned. Okay, is there anyone where when you talk to them itself, you get that happiness and satisfaction? What kind of people they are?
I get a lot of satisfaction in empowering youth. You know, when I go and they feel they can't do anything, they feel so this, they're directionless, you know, empowering them, I get a lot of satisfaction. Then another is couples, you know, when they're facing issues or even the parents, you know, when parenting, it is very difficult these days, you know, how. So I believe like when I ask my daughters, what do you think, what is my niche? You know, and they say, of course, parenting.
But as a single mom, you have brought them up very well with all the challenges still.
Okay? Yeah.
So that's many people get completely devastated in such challenges, right? But you're able to do that, right?
Amazing values they have. You will be surprised. I've seen your daughter too, and she's so fantastic. She's awesome. Even my daughters are there. So, real value-based people, you know, they really, they understand life so beautifully and they're doing so well in life. So they say parenting, and when I see professionals that they don't know how to deal with their jobs and how to deal with their, you know, they're ready to resign, they don't want to change themselves, you know, so I want to really guide them, you know, that how to really, you know, grow, and how you'll get promotion, not by just gossiping and keep talking about it, that why I'm not getting promoted. So I love to guide them. I love to, I really want how business people, they don't understanding how their systems are and how they are working. Even the marketing teams, you know, their minds are so stuck. They are not trained. They don't make that kind of effort with open mind. So I believe, you know, I can train with, I have that, but it's all with mind. You know, everything is to do with the mind. So I have dealt with extramarital relationship in my life. So I believe even they are my clients. You know,
I know you, everyone is can become your client, but you know that there's a very simple saying, no, everyone cannot be your clients.
And that's you start, my problem.
When you start looking everywhere, you actually look nowhere. The specific is really terrific. And that's what Trainer's Niche Blueprint course is all about. Now, when you start working that templates and workbook, you'll really find out. See, you, I know that as a life coach, you can actually help people from every aspect of life. But is there a way in which we can funnel it out to a specific target audience? And whatever you want to teach, can you narrow down to one target audience and create a whole course curriculum for them? So thereby, once you build that particular niche, then you can move to the next one. It's like your business itself, no? Like how you are doing that business. You built one business properly, automated the system, and then only you went into the next, and then only you go to the next. No? The same formula here also. Otherwise, you know, you will get scattered everywhere, and literally we want to do more. We can actually do more, but by the end of 10 years, if you look back, you will have actually helped only few people.
Yeah, actually, that is what my position is right now. So I see professionals, you know, like age group between 25 to
40. Your voice is breaking.
I believe it
should be fine. I can't hear
Hello?
You.
Hello? Is it okay? Can
you
hear me? Hello?
Yes, I can hear you now.
Okay. So, I believe professionals are could be my clients.
Okay.
Because they have multiple midlife crises. In terms of their jobs or business or finance or children or, you know, even relationships. So I believe that could be my client. I also believe that my passion is to bring about peace.
Peace for, you know, whom? Peace for whom, Ritu?
Peace for anybody and everybody, like conflict management. Conflict, you know, is very my core area. Like I'm part of Rotary, I'm part of various organizations.
Why can't you, okay, now this is one random idea to you. Why can't you call yourself as a conflict management coach?
Yeah,
so thereby,
I can.
It's all about conflicts because your life had been series of conflicts and you have been coming out of that conflict, right? So it's very easy for you to relate because people get devastated when they see a small conflict, when small trouble and small obstacle. Can you call yourself as a conflict management coach instead of saying a life coach? Because life coach is too big. In life, you can still narrow down to conflicts.
Yeah. So my daughter was also discussing yesterday. So
no, your voice has gone low down. I think you have to adjust your microphone, something where suddenly your voice is going down and up.
Is it better? I'm coming close to it. Yeah. Because otherwise there's
yeah,
no
now
change.
It's better. Now it's better. Something happens and
okay.
Goes down and up.
Yeah. So, you know, it's so conflict is a good area. Like, as I told you, I'm part of Rotary organization. I was assistant governor last year.
Okay.
So I am known to be peacemaker. There's a conflict, you know, so I can pitch in and try to talk to both the parties. So I have that quality. Uh-huh.
Yeah, I think since you have dealt with enough court cases, you are the best in the world to talk about conflicts, okay? How do you convert the conflicts into calmness or how do you convert the conflicts into peace?
Only thing is, now I believe that whether people will be able to, ready to pay, because there are a lot of egos in everyone, you know, those who I'm dealing, whether they are corporates or institutions or even husband-wife. So, you know, whether they will want to, they always, you know, in their mind, they believe the other person is wrong and they are full of ego. So, whether they will be ready to be, another conflict which I have with myself, Murali, I want to ask you.
What is like, that?
I am financially comfortable. You know, my daughters have said I have no problem as such. So, I am a giver. Like, you know, one of the baseline course we do. So, I am a giver. I am a peacemaker. So somewhere I have to, now I came to this point where I've started talking about money in life coach business. I have never thought about it. And I used to believe that people give, so what? I can give at least coaching. I can give counseling. I can empower people. So I don't need money. But now slowly I started feeling with a lot of coaching and guidance like from you or others, you know. So what I got it, no, you one should take money because then your coaching has some value. You know, people will value you and you can otherwise give that in charity. That's fine, but you should ask for. So that's how I come to this point. Otherwise, I was kind of, it's okay. It doesn't matter. So that is. So in conflict, whether people will be really ready to come.
Pay you money. Is that your constant? Okay, so let's go that go to that question a little deeper. Okay, so you are now clear that you are very good in handling conflicts because you are damn good at it, right?
Yeah.
So let's keep that as a subject of interest. Okay, that you are very good in solving conflicts and that comes naturally to you also because that's how you've been brought up in your whole life. Then let's go a little deeper to find out. Okay, now who has higher conflicts and they really value that peace? Okay, they are ready to pay you any money to get that peace. They want to come out of that conflict. Let's little go deeper. Among all the target audience that has enough conflicts, right? From husband and wife or an employee, the career transition conflicts, or a business owner going through huge conflicts in his life. It can be anyone, right? So whom do you think, according to you, in among these target audiences, who will actually pay huge value for conflict? For whom it is a big problem.
One area I see is that people have huge conflicts in their families and their properties are stuck, badly stuck.
Okay.
Know? And they are not able to resolve among them. And, you know, for years together, their children also suffer. They also suffer. They have problems, health issues. And they're leading poor men's life having huge properties because they are not able to resolve their dispute. That's what I strongly believe in. They don't have will, father has not done will, and a lot of, you know, this kind of. So this conflict I see a lot in society.
Okay.
I don't know whether they will come or not, you know, but somewhere I believe I have that image in, you know, if I see local market, I have a good image in terms of trust, in terms of, you know, values. So they can trust. Once if I establish my brand, so maybe people will start coming in thinking, yes, she let us go to her and, you know, find a solution. And I have a legal background also. I've done Master of Law. So that goes, though I will not apply law because I somehow don't trust law much, you know. But
at least you can give the legal side of it, right? Many people do not understand.
Yeah. So, and business conflicts, you know, even top management having problems or partners having problems or, you know, so scope is huge. Only
absolutely,
I think.
Absolutely. Huge conflict. But here is one thing. See, when we have to finalize our niche and where we want to focus upon, we need to find, you know, a way in which for whom the conflict is a huge problem, for which they are ready to pay any amount of money to get out of the conflict. They just need the right advice and the right person who can get them out of the conflict. So according to you, okay, do you think that people, the couples or people who are having property conflicts, okay, or business conflicts or corporate companies having conflicts, whom do you think because you have seen everything, according to you, whom do you think have a huge problem? They can pay you any money.
Yeah, and they can be,
And they should also value you also. Very important. Right? It's very important. It's not about paying money. They should value your advice and the way in which you have come in your life also. They have to understand that part of it.
Yeah, that is very important. Yeah. Because the clients I am thinking about who will have conflicts, they are very high profile clients, you know, in my mind, you know, properties, those who have property issues or corporates, you know. So only thing is they have huge ego. You know what this person is going to, we can resolve, we can, you know. So they will stick to their egos, you know. So that is a kind of little, though need is huge.
Yes. People need conflict mitigation coach like you. Okay. Basically, mitigation coach is a better name, where in which, you know, it's a mitigation, basically. Because both of them have egos, and basically the ego is what is causing them the whole conflict itself.
Yeah.
Only when a third person enters, they can show the two perspectives and make them understand. And you have solved many conflicts in your life. Right? Yeah, so you can add a lot of value to them.
Gone to corporates, I keep, top management, I had a session. So I spoke about conflict management. In Rotary, I've spoken about conflict management.
Excellent.
So this is very important, I believe. Only thing is, I think I need to brand myself strongly about it.
Yes, it's all about branding, Ritu. Absolutely true.
Yeah, I believe so. But I think I can do good there.
Yeah, do you think that conflict mitigation coach is a better name than a life, calling yourself as a life coach, because it's too broad, no?
Yeah, of course. Whether conflict management or conflict mitigation is also great. Yeah, both are great. Yeah.
Well, no, but that, you know, remember, whenever we are choosing a title for us, you know, that's the brand that we are going to build. We need to resonate with that. For example, when I resonate myself with happiness, because I'm always happy, whatever happened, it doesn't matter. Okay. So everyone can quickly connect with me. So whenever you speak, also people should be able to connect with you on the various conflicts that have gone through in your life and how you came out of it. So that's how the brand is built, with your authenticity.
TIV. So in that, I went to many friends and, people, and asked them what you can get from me, what you like to take advice on. So everybody said patience, empowerment, how you can relate to people, and time management, somebody said.
That can be part of your whole curriculum or coaching system itself, because to handle any conflict, you need to have patience.
Yeah, that's true. Now, how to build a course on that, or on this whole, that is a key point.
you will do that, and we are going to help you in our Teachers and Leaders community. Don't worry. That's the whole objective of helping you to build your course and help people. Okay. And at the same time, as you mentioned, your heart is also to help poor people. I know that, because it is there in yourself. And you can actually open up a foundation to help people also. For example, I run my own foundation, which I don't publicly announce it, but I spend a lot of money every single month on educating poor children. So, you know, whatever money I make, I give it over there. So you don't have to publicize it, whatever that. But still, as you mentioned, you need to brand yourself, and then you do attract the right target audience. And automatically, you can charge for it. They don't have any problem, because their problem is a bigger problem for them. So they need to get out of the problem. And you have the solution. You have the way out of it. You have done that in your life. Okay. So it's not something which you don't know.
Yeah, true. My heart is definitely to resolve issues. Towards peace. Create this society as a better place. And like my daughter, you will be surprised, elder one. You know, I was asking about the will, that what should I do, and So she told mama, make a trust and give it for education, so that people can, children can study, who want to go abroad and study, don't have that. And then they can refund 50% after earning it back. So that is the kind of heart even they have, So I really want to do well as a life coach or as a conflict mitigation coach, and then really contribute to society. That is what my heart is. Yeah.
Excellent, excellent, Ritu. So now, are you clear on your niche? Are you okay with that particular topic? Life coaching, you're just narrowing it down and say, okay, in life, what exactly I'm coaching? Conflicts. Thereby, you can get into peace, because peace is broken because of conflict.
Yeah, as of now, I was writing myself, if you have noticed, winning attitude, winning mindset coach. Yes. Because I also believe that people don't have right attitude, mental attitude. That's why they don't win. So they need to understand where they're lacking. So yeah. That's what how I thought, you know, that I could really guide them, whatever area of their life is, I can guide them, why they are failing, if they are failing, why children are not doing well, what values you are giving to children or to your corporate or to your employees or to your boss. So I thought that could also be one area, because it could be time management, it could be anger management, it could be anything what I actually already teach, the life skills, whatever. So they are missing on that. If you ever get time, you can watch my videos, you know. So there I teach all these things. That how. So it, that is what also I thought, winning mindset.
And now, Ritu, since you also went through John Maxwell programs, okay, he's my great teacher also in my life. You see, whatever you have mentioned right now, if you read his books or any of his sessions, he's talking the same. But he doesn't position himself as a winning mindset coach, because that's a very lower level and too many people are there, motivational speakers. He calls himself as the highest level as leadership, okay? As a leadership coach, okay? As a leadership authority, not even a coach. He calls himself as the leadership authority in the world. And then inside, everything is taught. You go into, I think you already attended the program, you know that that's the greatest way in which people actually position themselves, okay? Inside to their target audience, they teach everything. But from the outside perspective, they know whom they want to attract in their life, okay? For example, leadership conflict management coach is actually a bigger topic. That means you're only talking to leaders only, not to anyone else below. So even for the conflict, okay, conflict mitigation coach means to whom? Is the next question that you have to ask. Okay, is it for leaders? Is it for executives? Is it for CEOs? Or is it for women? You know, that's the next thing that you have to go one step further. Okay, once you understand, okay, this is my favorite subject topic, I can manage it. Then the next step goes is, okay, to whom? Okay, what's the target audience? And in that, you can actually build everything you want, a winning mindset, and everything comes inside as you start layering it to them. And that's how you build a product out of your knowledge.
Can I say business leaders and professionals?
Business leaders and professionals. Professionals means, are you talking about people working in the corporate atmosphere or professionals like lawyers, architects, doctors?
No, I mean corporate offices, those who work.
Corporate, and in the corporate world, whom exactly? Is it the middle level manager or the CEO, CXO, CTOs, or the lower level? You know, everywhere it's a huge market, you know, the whole huge thing. That means senior management level, right? Okay, so senior management level means corporate executives at the topmost senior management levels, like CEOs and CXOs and CTOs. And you want to work with them? Yes, absolutely. You can work with them, but for that, you need to build your brand first. And so that they start inviting you for their personal coaching, because there are a lot of corporate executive coaches are there where they personally go and hire executive coaches. And most of the time, the corporate companies hire such executive coaches, and these people go through. Sometimes they personally go out and get themselves coached also. So both the markets there. But ultimately, the corporates, if they have to hire you to coach their team, they need to see you as a brand. That you have worked and done that and you are doing that. So that's the reason why the brand building is really, really essential now.
Yeah. So what I see, the two things are important right now for me, if you identify this as a niche. So
one is that we need to make it a brand, and secondly, to make a course on that, right?
Yes, absolutely. You need to have that curriculum with you. Either it can be an online course curriculum or an offline workshops or one-to-one coaching method. So we need to create our own template. Okay, you need to get all your, you know, content out of your head. And that's what we're going to do in level 3. We're going to do everything, get everything out of your head and put it in a template so that your products are ready right now. Okay, how do you get your products? Okay, how do you funnel it down the whole products itself?
Right. So, okay. So therefore, then I'll get guidance from you, right?
Yes, absolutely. Yes, that's what we are going to do in our
year. Give it a shape, you know, make it a system. Yeah.
Yeah, we need to make it as a system. Yeah, true. We need to productize that knowledge and systemize it so that it can reach more people. So yeah. Only when it is systemized and productized, it can reach more people. Like your business itself. No, if it's not a product, you will not would have reached and built a huge company like this so far.
Right.
Similarly, the same way we need to productize it so that we can go to that particular right target market. So what you say is right now business leaders and the corporate heads.
Yeah, corporate.
Or senior management.
Yeah, we can say because vice presidents and all, they also come into that.
Oh, yeah, yeah, you know? Absolutely. Yeah. Senior management, basically senior management.
Yeah.
Interesting, very, very interesting. Two niche you have, okay, two verticals. Basically, one is the business leaders community, business leaders like you, who also go through enough varieties of conflicts.
Huge.
And then you are senior manager, but ultimately both are in the conflict level. That's the reason in TNB, if you go through the whole course, I will say that there are three kinds of niches. Okay, long tail, medium tail and small tail.
Okay.
That means too broad, medium broad, very narrow broad. Okay.
Right.
We start with a narrow target audience and slowly move towards a medium segment, but don't make it super, super broad. So you need to start in a specific target market and grow it a little bigger so that it can cover and encompass a huge target audience also, a medium level of target audience. But I think what you have said right now makes sense. You can start somewhere either at the corporate senior management leadership team first or the business leaders first and build your brand name and then slowly, slowly, slowly expand and cover both these markets.
And another is it could be in real life,
apart from businesses, that we have families, they also have huge conflicts. As I said, it could be about will or properties or even relationships. They're fighting in courts and they don't know it's a long 20 years of fight, you know, happening. So no solution. So this could also be one sector. So what do you suggest?
They're all very good sectors and family conflicts are huge, very huge. And people end up in spending truckloads of money to solve the conflicts, which they could have just done it in a very easier way. Okay, because since you're a lawyer, you understand the minute they get into that particular legal path, the amount of money they spend in the legal system is huge. Okay? Probably if they hire a coach like you who has mastered in law, but tells them, don't go there, we can solve it at a fraction of a price itself, they will jump into your system itself. So that's another market that is available for you.
So if I call myself family conflict resolution coach, I'm just thinking aloud.
Again, if you niche yourself as a family conflict resolution coach, you will miss out on the corporate world and the business world.
Okay.
So that's the reason the name, let it be little generic as a conflict resolution coach, a conflict resolution coach or conflict mitigation, whichever word resonates with you. Okay. So thereby you stay there as a brand at the top, then you can have verticals within. Okay. One vertical is business leaders. One vertical is the corporate senior management conflict. And one vertical can be the family. So three different verticals you can actually have and help. Does that make sense to you?
Yeah, it makes sense.
So accordingly, but again, everything boils down to conflicts. Okay. So all your Facebook live videos, your YouTube videos, whatever marketing materials that you produce, everything should boil around conflicts.
Okay. Right. Now today onwards I'll start.
What? I can't hear you.
Today only I'll start.
Okay. So that it becomes easier, no? So that all your communication, see, whenever you communicate, it has to sync with whatever you want to connect people with, no? So the minute think it's like anchoring, okay? So they think of problems and conflict, they have to think of Ritu Singhal.
Right. I will start today. Yeah. I'm excited, actually. I'm excited.
Because actually, I want this world to be a better place. I want people should lead a healthy life. I want people should come out of this unnecessary conflicts they've created in their lives.
Very true. Absolutely. I really agree with you. Because people make the life so cumbersome by making too much of mental conflicts and physical conflicts, emotional conflicts, financial conflicts, and the spiritual conflicts. There are too much of spiritual conflicts. Too much. That's what I love the word that you said, no, conflicts resolution coach. I said, wow, it's an amazing topic to cover because everyone will immediately resonate with it. Instead of saying peace coach, conflict coach is much better word because negativity attracts faster.
Okay. So I should take it as
conflict resolution coach, conflict mitigation. So what do you suggest? let's name it.
The minute you add the word mitigation, then it looks like a legal process. Okay, the word mitigation is connected to legal system. Okay, so since you buy your profile also says lawyer, you will only have that kind of people walking into your life. Okay? So I will suggest you not to have that mitigation because you want to deal with all the three verticals. Conflict management coach or conflict resolution coach is a better word because both the positive and negative is there in the same sentence itself. Conflict, yeah. Negative, positive.
Fine. I'm very comfortable. Yeah.
With conflict resolution coach. Wow. So whenever you talk in Facebook Live and I'll say, hey, my name is Ritu Singhal. I'm a conflict resolution coach and I'm an entrepreneur and I'm running this business and I've seen enough conflicts in my life. So today I'm going to share with you one conflict I gone through in my personal life or my business life and how I shared with you. So tell stories like this. Tell a lot of stories and maybe if possible, whenever you're free, take a notebook and write all the stories where you have gone through in your life and see the amount of conflicts you have handled.
Murli, I'm writing my autobiography and it's almost, I've done 80%.
Wow.
If you can just think of any name, you know now in my story, how it can attract people and, you know, what can I do about it? My book was A Story Can Change Your Life.
Okay.
And now I used to laugh. Now I'll write My Story Can Change Your Life. So now if you can suggest later, you can think about it because I think that is also very important because I dealt with a lot of corruption and I'm writing that also in my book.
Okay, interesting. No, I will give you some interesting title also. And
yeah, it will be nice. Yeah,
yeah, yeah. Yeah. I'll share with you some interesting title based on what I heard from you and know you very well. And I will give you some interesting suggestions and see how that can resonate with your autobiography.
Great. Yeah.
Good. I hope you got some clarity in this one-to-one session.
Lot of clarity. One thing more I want to ask. Can this niche work in international market?
Absolutely true. That's a huge market available internationally also. Yes. See, conflicts are there everywhere, no? It doesn't matter. And family conflicts are huge in outside India. Corporate conflicts, huge. For example, in the Western world, corporate conflicts is huge and they don't want to spend to the legal system because it's a huge money. They end up in being partners fighting with each other. There's a huge dispute. So if you can establish yourself as an authority in the whole conflict resolution, it's a huge market available. Huge market. The global market is available for you.
There are already coaches in this area?
Yes, yes. There are few conflict resolution coaches are there in the whole world, but very few. And I have not seen any women conflict resolution coach so far.
In India?
Mostly it is men. I have never seen a woman. Even in India, I don't see many women coaches. Very few women speakers, women coaches are there. And then you will become an amazing inspiration for many women to come out and fight and have that freedom in their life.
Fine. Thank you. Thank you so very much. Yeah, I'm enjoying this course like anything.
Okay. Will you recommend this course to anyone? What kind of people will you recommend this program, Teachers Are Leaders program?
Yesterday, I recommended to one of my friends who really
forward to me as a senior or a coach. So she thought if I am doing so, she will love to do. So okay. I am recommending. She's a HR head in one of very, 200 crore company. So Okay. She wanted to become coach.
Very good.
Yeah, I'm recommending this because I believe you're giving a lot of value. That is what my, so you're giving proper system and value to clients.
Thank you, Ruth. Because I think our objective is very simple. We run our own businesses, but still we want to create world-class teachers. That's the whole objective because I believe everyone are teachers. If you are a parent, you are a teacher. If you are a business owner, you are a teacher because you are continuously empowering people and teacher leaders. Every teacher is a leader and that's the reason we call teacher leaders, right? So goal is to create 100,000 world-class teachers. So that's the reason why we wanted to give as much as possible. Whatever we knew, we are just sharing with everyone in our community. And people like you, when you start sharing your life story, you're actually making the whole community so strong and vibrant. because every even whatever you share, even this particular discussion that we had, when the other coaches in our community and others see this, they will really get inspired from your life story, right? But that's what a teacher does, right? We bring in that inspiration with Nitin and tell them, yes, you can solve any problem in your life. You can actually achieve peace in your life, right? So that's satisfaction.
I recommended this to a few teachers also. Those who are doing well in school, but they want to, expand their life, do more in life.
So I've recommended that to them also. I'm recommending to many people because I believe, whatever potential is in them, they can really manifest. They will be
absolutely
helped.
Absolutely. I always remember John Maxwell's quote, no? The God's gift to you is your potential, and your return gift is to explore that potential and give it back to him. That's a beautiful quote of John Maxwell.
Yes.
Everyone has that potential. Okay, so I hope this one-to-one session was useful for you to bring more clarity.
Last question. The tagline which you
said, either give up or fight back, So will this go with this conflict resolution?
Absolutely. No, in every conflict, you have two options, right? Either you give up or fight back. Okay, that's a perfect tagline. Okay?
Okay,
go ahead and do that, because that's your statement you made in the last webinar. That's a beautiful statement. There are two options in life: either you give up or fight back. Give up is not an option. Please brand yourself. Put your photographs. Put the quote everywhere, so that that becomes a strong message to the whole world itself. That any conflicts, don't give up. Fight it out, and there is always an answer to every conflict. That can be a tagline of yours itself. It can be your tagline. Give up or fight back. It's a tagline. That's it. And that's what you have done in your life so far, right? You could have just easily given up, but you didn't.
True.
That's the reason you are a superwoman, Ritu.
Thank you, Murli. Thank you for really guiding us. Thank you for making this journey so
easy, actually. When somebody is there to guide you at every point of time with this kind of personal interactions, I have not seen anywhere. Where you get a chance. That's why when, I saw that I had more comments and even likings, even views. I had even more views also. I had 13,000 or more.
Nice.
So I felt I've lost chance to meet you. That was my, it was not about my picture there, but it was more about the chance.
My pleasure. And that was an amazing challenge. You took it and did it. So we'll continue sharing more on Facebook. But again, everything now boiled down to what we discussed now, so that you can actually go and empower a lot of people, convert conflicts to calmness, convert conflicts to peace, problems to peace. So thereby, you can help a lot of people. I'm super happy that you have joined our community and helping a lot of people. Continue to serve the community, Ritu. Thank you very much for that.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Murli.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.